far, really, has just been a couple of poor turnovers by Waikato. Really unfortunate there, a good contest just ended up coming off the head of the Waikato player. Unfortunate there, just a little contact. Still a really tight game, there's really only three turnovers in it. And anyone who's played the game knows how quickly that can change. Great two hands there from Mark Sutton. Secures the rebound. Won't be happy with that though, missing the follow-up. This is a really good opportunity for Waikato to get themselves back into it. Close to a step there. Umpire thought about it. Beautiful little behind-the-back pass. Creates a nice little triangle for the Waikato mid-quarters. And then... a lot of looks at umpires at the moment. Players, I think, need to just get on with the game and play it. Some really good contesting going on. Great take there. And a beautiful finish by the goal shooter from Waikato. They're trying to force Wellington wide on the attack, down the attacking end. Beautiful take there by Mark, and good finish. I'd love to see Waikato's centre get a little bit more involved in the play, but I think that was unfortunate. A really good turnover. Unfortunately, two players holding on to the ball at the same time meant that Waikato got the ball back. Fantastic rebounding position by the Wellington goal defender there. Time stops so that we can get a towel on the court. Like I was saying before, I'd love to see the Waikato centre JJ Sherrick get a little bit more involved in the play. At the moment, I think John Casey's just getting the better of that matchup. Maybe just a little bit more pre-work to get himself open, because he's shown when he gets the ball near circle edge, he's got great vision. Beautiful piece of defence though by JJ Sherrick there. And that might be just the thing to start getting him into this game. Nice little feed into the front space there. Right out in front. A few little misses by Mark Sutton here. Would be nice to see him go up with a bit more confidence and put the ball in the hoop. Just looks like he's rushing it at the moment. Beautiful tip by JJ there. You may not have seen that on camera, but the Waikato centre, JJ Sherrick, just took the opportunity to take a quick little breather around the corner while the umpires had the clock stop. That's a veteran move if ever I've seen one. JJ Sherrick just going offside means that Wellington get a free pass inside the circle. A little step away feed. Tipped by Waikato, and maybe Wellington just getting a little bit cute there. I think they need to just use the edge of the circle. They had two middies on the circle edge in strong positions. Wellington goal shooter, Mark Sutton, looking exhausted out there. Beautiful feed in. Great work getting it to the goal attack. Good use of the post there, just to get himself a little bit closer and give himself a moment to get composed. Wellington up 22-15 here. It's been a really tight battle. unfortunate there, forcing himself out of court. Tried to control it off the post, but jumped in from out of court when he regained possession. Beautiful drive by Lee. They need a lot more of that punching for the ball, because at the moment they're having to go over the top a lot more than they would like to, and really introducing Wellington into some contests. Beautiful read there by Chanel from the goal defence from Wellington, and in return from the goal defence from Waikato. Just ability to read the line of the ball was fantastic there. Another feed into Mark, and he looked a bit more composed on that finish. Waikato throw on the baseline. Let's see how they... Both their midfielders have fantastic position. Obstruction from the Wellington goalkeeper on the inbound gave the ball an easy shot for the Waikato goal shooter, Lark Sinclair. Waikato still working through that mid-court zone, really trying to force the ball wide and high. And they've done just that. Beautiful pickup by JJ. And some great work through the midcourt, but just stifling a little bit here. I think the goal shooter may have just got his timing off trying to drive through. Beautiful feed to the goal attack. That's more like it from Waikato. A bit more of that. That midcourt zone working a really good, doing a really good job for them there. Waikato wing attacks, really controlling the speed of play here. Nice little finish. Brings Waikato back with him. Five. This game is by no means over with a quarter and 3 minutes to play. Just down five. Sweep of the front by Wellington goal attack. Fortunately couldn't make the goal count, but another great piece of rebounding by Mark Sutton. I've been really impressed with his athleticism. He's obviously a big solid guy, but he's moving really well athletically, going for those rebounds and chasing the loose ball. Tangle up there. Great thing about watching this grade is the sportsmanship's just outstanding. They're all playing hard, but it's all done with a smile on their face. Fantastic contest there. The Waikato circuit are really tightening up and pushing Mark Sutton into areas that he's not as comfortable in. And it is making it a lot harder for the Wellington feeders to get the ball into him. Great little drive through the middle. Mark Sutton holding really good front space there. Just under a minute to play. Good little give and go there between the Waikato wing attack and goal attack. And swings the front beautifully. Unfortunately can't make the goal count. Leads out to 8, 30 seconds left in the quarter. Some really good work through the midcourt by Waikato there. Just couldn't quite finish the goal at the end under some really good pressure on the lane. Great chase back by the Waikato goal defence to get that one back. They got 15 seconds to try and get this ball down court. Beautiful little change of direction. It's a caution to the Wellington centre there. Trying to force the contact, doing it intentionally to give them the best chance of slowing down play. What a shot by the Waikato goal shooter, Lars Sinclair, to finish the quarter. That'll give them a little bit of confidence going into this last quarter. That is the end of the third quarter here at Te Rauparaha Arena, with Wellington leading 26-19, and we will be back after the break. Like a few changes on for both teams. Chance to stretch the legs for a few players and for some others to have a bit of a break. I am surprised to see Mark Sutton come out, as he has been on his hands on knees heaving for most of that last quarter. But his role obviously very important within this side. Goalkeeper Simon Bree doing a really good job of forcing him high. Nice little feed in. Players from both teams really getting themselves in trouble, trying to step on and pass, really getting themselves closer to those hands and creating a lot of trouble. So I would like to see a little bit more control, especially from Waikato, as they are trying to come back into this match. Beautiful read by the Wellington goal defence there, coming through the middle. Beautiful swing ball to Hannah O'Connor. Contact from the goal defender there. Great pass into Mark Sutton, just taking his time on this one and putting it through. From the mid-third into the goal attack. Fortunately, can't put the shot away though. Waikato really need to make sure of these turnovers to give themselves a chance in this match. Wellington centre John Casey doing a power of work, really denying them space on the circle edge, forcing the Waikato mid-quarters high, not giving them an easy feed in. Great pressure by the Wellington attack. I would like to see the Waikato attack really just have some confidence shooting the ball. At this point, those little passes are just too risky for what you're trying to do. Beautiful change of direction from Hannah O'Connor. Good hands by Simon Bree down there. Really attacking the flight of the ball once he had lost his shooter. Massive strong take from Mark Sutton. That connection's a really strong, clear one between John Casey and Mark Sutton. Clearly played a bit together and understand the space really well. Unlucky there from Lee Emery. She has moved into centre. Just losing control of the ball and ended up stepping as a result. Thank you. instruction call by goalkeeper Simon Bree. And it'll pass into Mark Sutton for the finish. Wellington leading 30-19 here. The score really starting to blow out. But good to see both teams still playing with good spirits. Beautiful little pocket ball. Really well done by Wellington goaltender Chanel by faking the pass across the circle and drawing the goalkeeper off the shooter, giving her the easy pass to post. Beautiful feed in. Great front space by the Waikato goal shooter. And the finish to go with it. Did a really good job of controlling the front space and forcing the contact out of Hori. Oh, unlucky by the goal defender there. Did a really good job and then just obstructed at the last moment. By Simon Bree, the goalkeeper. He's doing a great job once he's lost his man of going and attacking the flight of the ball, which does give him a chance to force an error out of Wellington. Looks like a fun matchup in the midcourt there. In the game. Great front space by Mark Sutton. Waikato centre pass down 32-20. Beautiful read by Hori coming out to pick that one off. Really good netball there for Wellington. You can tell they've clearly played together a lot. Just some of those connections through the midcourt. Beautiful outside arm. Great follow-up by the goal defender. That is exactly what we like to see. Those two working so well in the circle together. Fortunately, the pass out doesn't match it. And good rebounding position by Mark Sutton, cleaning up the missed shot. 4 minutes left in the Masters final. Wellington leading currently 34-20. Unfortunately just stepped in and obstructing. Nobody looks all that keen to chase that ball down. You can tell it is day four of the tournament. Beautiful confidence by the Waikato goal shooter to step out and shoot that. They need a lot more of that, just to turn and shoot, see if they can force a turnover down the other end. Beautiful feed from Mark Sutton. And a nice feed with the defender's eyes down. Nice shooting. Wellington goal attack. Beautiful tip by Hori. Controls it to himself, goes long. Wellington straight out on the break again. And a beautiful long shot by the Wellington goal attack. Started off the game really tentative shooting the ball, but now that it's out of reach, she's got the confidence to just turn and put the ball up and back herself to put it in. And another beautiful baseline drive. Gives this one up to Mark, who puts it in. See some tired legs really starting to take over in this last quarter, but it really has been a great contest all the way throughout. Another brilliant intercept by Hori. Did a great job controlling and balancing himself. Another long shot by the Wellington goal attack. Unfortunately, that one just rolling out. Thank you.
Good.
Much better through court from Waikato here. And a great little dodge by the Waikato goal shooter. Into the goal attack, and a nice easy goal. Beautiful outside arm by Simon Bree. Unfortunately, can't quite get to the second one. But a great little first tip, and a nice finish by Mark. It's been really competitive at both ends of the floor. I think Wellington's really just edged it through the midcourt. They've been able to force a lot of turnover ball by contesting and forcing Waikato off the circle edge. Beautiful control by JJ there. Horry came out for the hunt but couldn't quite manage it. And he did a great job controlling his feet to be able to get the ball in. Unfortunately, not able to get the finish. Might have been a little bit ambitious for day four. On day one, she might have jumped for that, but I don't think she's going to with 30 seconds left on day four. Seconds left. Let's see if Waikato can get one more in. Oh, unfortunately, footwork call there, just trying to get it in too quickly. And over a third call, just a little bit too ambitious. That is the end of our Masters Grade Final, with Wellington taking it out 38-22 over Waikato Tainui. Thank you so much for joining us, and we will be back with the B grade final in a little while. At 11:30. There we go.